Welcome to Detox. And in this one, Mr. David Patterson of Lake Country. How you doing, brother?
I'm doing awesome. You?
I'm so happy to have you here finally.
I'm happy to be here.
This has been a long time coming. So, like I said, David works for Lake Country Manufacturing, and most of you probably don't know about Lake Country. You probably use the pads, you use them for years, but not a lot of people know how long Lake Country's been around or what they make, or that they have, you get wool from farmers, from sheep,
yep,
to manufacture the pads.
Yeah, and actually that's kind of where it started. So Lake Country started in 1977, and it started as a company that did a few different products, and one of them was facial powder puffs for applying makeup, leather dice cups, and sheepskin buffing pads. So the sheepskin
kind
buffing
of a
pad
wild,
was
yeah.
kind of where it started.
So the sheepskin buffing pad, leather dice cups for playing dice.
Yep.
And then the powder pad, the puff powder. I remember my mom had one
when
I was a kid.
Absolutely. And now they have the new age powder puffs, which are foam. I'm totally another topic. But either way, so yeah, the other portions of the business were sold off and focused on buffing pads for the most part. And as the market grew, it grew from sheepskin to other types of wool pads. And then having some involvement in some of the first foam pads for DA sanders in the market, and also being responsible for bringing European pre-polymer foams to the United States.
So,
So our vice president is main focus is on product development, and he's pretty much the patent holder for the company. He designs a lot of things. I want to say somewhere around like 19 active patents, 27 total.
Wow.
Yeah, he's a very impressive guy, and he was one of the reasons pre-polymer foams came to the U.S. and it was something completely new. And right now, I would say 90%, but a good 80 to 90% of the foams that you would use for buffing today are European pre-polymer foams.
Okay.
So
yeah.
So it was a big thing for Lake Country. The next big thing was the CCS pattern. So I'm sure you're familiar with that, and it's a collapsed cell structure. And what it is by using heat and pressure, you can partially collapse a polyurethane foam. You're not melting it, but you're able to close those cells. So what happens is the product typically migrates into the middle of the pad,
right?
And those CCS dimples help prevent that or slow it down.
Okay.
But they also increase the working time because the polish is still in those pockets as you're working, so it stays wet or moist longer. And the biggest benefit of it is it's very similar to a waffle. So it breaks surface friction, and typically that's going to be associated with a rotary polisher or rotary buffer.
Yep.
Some people call it a high speed, but these days they're not really running that high.
Yeah.
So it's really a low speed polisher, but a zero offset, just a spinning polisher, it breaks that friction and it reduces the chatter or hop that you might get from heat and friction while polishing. So it drastically reduces that. So it offers the same type of a value as a waffle pad. But what's really unique about it is when you press it flat, if you were to use a piece of glass and you hold that pad up with, you know, 5 or 10 pounds pressure, a waffle pad is completely flat.
Right.
It just has pinpointed pressure from the compression.
Right.
Whereas a CCS pad, you push it flat against the panel.
Those dimples still.
They're still there. Right. So you're still breaking friction. You're still cooling the surface. You're still avoiding that user experience that you don't want.
Okay.
That's really where Lake Country took off, because at that point, the only thing that was out was a waffle.
Yeah. So. Yeah, for years it was waffle and foam.
Yeah.
Or not waffle foams and then wool.
Yeah.
That was the only two types of pads. You can get a flat waffle or...
Yeah, and that was it.
And
it's amazing to think about that in terms of years and what we've come to.
Oh yeah, for years that's all we used.
Yep.
And then in the last few years, like the advent of like your HDOs, the foam, purple foamed wool, just the DA itself and the available cutting power that it can do, it's unbelievable.
Yeah, and there's been so many different pads and products throughout the last decade. And all of them have offered some, whether they're from Lake Country or anybody, have offered some sort of significant value, which is why they've been out or stayed out. But what has changed in the last 5 years, we'll say, is In my opinion, is the truth in detailing. And yeah. Unless a product provides some significant value, whether that's increasing your speed, increasing your quality, a more durable long product, a better user experience, it has to make you more money or offer that value in order for that product to be a staple in our industry.
Yep.
So things are changing a little bit, and that combined with tools.
Yeah.
Tools have changed so much.
Oh,
that,
yeah.
A lot of those pads that were the best of the best need a little bit of tweaking and to be in our new generation of polishers.
Yep, especially as all the new polishers keep
coming
changing
out.
And
yeah.
and
that's,
you know,
a good
figuring
thing,
out heat.
But
it keeps everybody on their toes.
Yep.
And yeah. It allows you guys as the end user to really reap the benefits of years of R&D, so to speak, and testing and training and teaching, and it's really amazing now what new guys have available to them.
When I remember getting my first Porter cable.
Yeah.
So it was to think that it's gone from a rotary polisher and a DA, like a Porter cable or a Dynabrade or whatever was used as that sander, to however many tools we have on our market today is just amazing. And that's been the same for pads and polishes and microfiber towels. So it's really given our market just this boost to kind of elevate our standards.
Yeah, which is always good. Yeah. So if you guys want to learn more about Lake Country Manufacturing and all the stuff they do, the history of the company, all that stuff, check out lakecountrymfg.com.
Yep.
You can check out Lake Country on Facebook and Instagram under Lake Country Manufacturing. Find David Patterson on Facebook and Instagram. And comment below if you got any questions or comments. Make sure you like this video. And remember to stay tuned for more Detox right here on the Rag Company YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.